Jonathan Paula presents Game Time.
Greetings, Hotshot, and welcome back to my Uncharted 4 Let's Play on the PlayStation 4. Let's continue where we left off in the last video. What do I got here? Cereal? Wheat? Pasta? We made our way into the kitchen pantry. Congratulations. Bunch of milk crates. Some booze. A big hourglass. More booze and wine. A door behind some boxes. This guy's like a hoarder. All right, call A&E. Let's get a special on here. We got at least 3 episodes of content with this guy.
Hey, Nathan, check me out. Now, who am I? Huh? Dr. Livingston, come on.
Ah, you're a funny guy.
Nice.
All right, let's check out the kitchen, which makes sense that we're here. Opposite the kitchen pantry. Have an oscillating fan on the countertop in the corner. I don't know if that's a good place for a fan. Can't get much airflow, but hey, not my kitchen. Make your own choices in life. Got all the modern conveniences, including what looks like an old microwave oven. Well, what do we have here? Another note. I just leave them all over the place.
Man, what I wouldn't give to get an invite like this.
Adventurer's Lodge Annual Holiday Gala. It's been a while. I do hope you'll join us this year. Charles.
The holiday gala with Charles. Yes, of course. Yes, the gala. Everyone's gonna be there. Of course, you don't want to be left out, do you?
What's this?
Fertility totems.
Hey, aren't you a little young to be looking at
Look
that stuff?
Look at the tits on that.
Aren't you a little old to be making that joke?
Hey-o! Nah, I have to agree with Sam on this one. You're never too old to make a titty joke. Titty. It's a fun word to say and an even funner thing to hold in your hands. Am I right? Of course I'm right. Don't be ridiculous. There's not even a debate here. Tits are super duper. Everyone likes them.
Wow. This table's as big as the ones in the orphanage dining hall.
Wow.
I bet the food here was better.
Was?
Wouldn't take much.
They must have thrown some great parties in here.
Judging by the artifacts, they certainly had enough money for it.
Yeah. Looks like it's been a long time since the last one, though.
Unfortunately, I believe you're right about that. And I'm curious, why is this whole room, this whole house, just abandoned? You know, I don't know. I feel like we are going the right way. He's still wearing that dog ugly hat. I think we're going the right way, so let me explore this room before... Yeah, this is the dead end. Let me just explore real quick.
Hey, check it out.
Now I'm gonna wear the dumb hat too. All right, great. What's this, a book? Ooh, a globe. I've been all around this great big world and I've seen all kinds of girls.
Where would you pick?
I just can't wait to get back to the States, back to the cutest girls in the world. I wish they all could be California.
Here we go.
Ding!
India.
Yeah, we'll visit the Taj Mahal.
Woo! Round and round she goes.
Right there.
Soviet Union.
Shambhala.
Let's go to Moscow.
Yeah, it might be a tad difficult to get in. I always wanted to see the Red Square, though.
Let's try again.
Ding, ding, ding.
England. Sure would be cool to see Windsor Castle. Right, Sam?
Hey, don't look at me. It's not my fault you weren't born yet. It's not like I remember much of it anyways. And it wasn't that cool.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. One last spin.
Madagascar?
Brazil.
Hey, now you're talking. All kinds of undiscovered places in the rainforest.
And all kinds of undiscovered tribes with poison darts.
Yeah. That too.
Stop moving around. I was trying to get a photo of you, you weird kid. See, now I can get the photo. If I do this... The Brothers Drake. The Brothers Drake. Let's go to brightness. Turn that up with scotch. A little bit more than a scotch, but it works. And screenshot with his stupid little Dr. Livingston hat and my Hail Caesar getup. I think it's a good screenshot there. What do we got here?
I just read this one.
Oh, yeah? Is it any good?
It's kind of incredible. It's about the first Western woman to visit Lhasa.
What or where is that? Sorry, I don't know everything. All right, so we've explored this area. Let's continue where I was about to go, which is past this big dining room area. Ooh, another letter. Let's read it. Evelyn, it's 9 o'clock on Tuesday morning here, which means it's afternoon in Arabia. I hope you are finding the heat bearable. The queen of Sheba at least had an entourage accompanying her and her treasure. Wait, let me try this sentence again because it's kind of a wordy. The queen of Sheba at least had an entourage accompanying her and her treasure on her journey to Solomon. Thanks to my foolish behavior, you are retracing that journey alone. We always agreed that we should strive to live a life of our own choosing, free of regret and missed opportunities. At the airport, my thoughts were not of the present, but of the future. I simply have a hard time reconciling the whirlwind life we live around the world versus the one we live at home. No matter how intense our disagreement, I should not have cast doubt on your commitment to our family. I deserved your admonishment, and I understand why you left without me. In the spirit of Solomon, we must find a way to seek compromise. Until then, I wish you the very best of luck. Edmund and I shall be eagerly awaiting your return. Love, Ken. Well, there's some marital trouble there in this rich family. Between Evelyn and Ken. Antiquity seekers.
Hey, check out this crazy demon helmet.
Is that a Viking helmet?
Come on. You know Viking helmets don't have horns. It's Persian.
I like this hat better.
Oh, my bad.
Can you imagine being the one to actually uncover these things?
Must be something, right?
Something indeed. Something indeed. Another box. Perhaps the thing we're finally looking for? I don't know. This is more of a story-based mission, really.
Whoa. Lawrence of Arabia.
Always wanted to see that flick. Never got around to it, though.
Yeah, me neither. One of these days. One of these days I'll get to it. Look at all these implements of destruction. Circles and arrows on the back of each one. It's a weapons hall. All right. This house is a lot bigger than I suspected. I thought we were reaching the end of it, but it's just getting bigger.
Looks French.
Is this the front door over here?
Hey, maybe don't go waving your flashlight around the windows too much.
Don't tell me what to do. I'll wave my flashlight wherever I want.
Or you could just not listen to me.
I mean, is it possible like that we could actually like fail this mission? This seems like an unfailable mission, right? All right, what do we... Jesus, this is a huge frickin' place. A huge frickin' place. Oh, jeez. It gets bigger and bigger.
A dragon gong. Huh. Looks like it's from Southeast Asia. Going it alone.
Adventure life. I love how useless the rotate function is. This is a nice big greenhouse here, huh?
Hey, they've got your favorite book here.
A general history of the robberies and murders of the most notorious pirates.
A general history of the robberies and murders of the most notorious pirates.
I just read that.
Yeah, more like a generally made-up history. Even the author's name is a fake.
It is. Captain Charles something. I can't read it. I don't know if they want us to read it.
Fake or not, this looks like a first edition.
Are you serious? Man, this place, man. Wow.
Want to take it with you?
Nah. It'll just disintegrate in my backpack.
I thought we came here to steal shit.
You could sell it. Then you wouldn't need to take that job.
Well, tonight, let's just stick with what already belongs to us.
Ah, they're getting into the thievery business early, these two Drake bros, huh? I want to steal everything. I want it all. Ooh, another long letter with a photo on the back. Let's check it out. Evelyn, I happened across the latest issue of Adventure Life and was both surprised and delighted to see you grace its cover once again. I am pleased to see you looking so happy, still doing what you enjoy. In spite of our separate lives, your accomplishments still bring me no small amount of pride. Attached is the photo from Edmund's graduation, top of his class. I guess we did something right. Though he would kill me if he knew I told you, I want you to know that Edmund was devastated when you chose to journey to India without him this past summer. He has grown into a capable and self-assured young man. His flashes of insight remind me of you, particularly the look that crosses his face just before that eureka moment. What's more, he loves and admires you more than I can express. I've had my share of struggles over the years, and I've never asked you for anything. I'm now asking you to take Edmund on your next journey. I know it'll be a challenge, and you might not move at the pace you're used to, but I promise you this. You'll find a joy, the likes of which no one else can provide. I look forward to hearing about your next big find. Keep making all of us proud. With warm regards, Ken. So they're divorced treasure seekers with an 18-year-old son named Edmund. And they go around the world and collect all these artifacts.
Look at these. Compass, sundial.
Just imagine being lost at sea. And those instruments are the only thing standing between death and salvation.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
It's crazy.
Nice big boat. The Fancy. Ooh, that's Avery's boat. Finally getting a good look at it. We haven't actually seen it yet in this game. The Fancy. I have to say, the dynamic lighting in this game, the shadows, incredible. Like, it's sort of remarkable how powerful and how realistic everything in this game looks. Striking. I think upstairs is probably where we're supposed to go, so let's try out this big room here first. There's so many things to look at. I'm sorry that this episode is sort of boring and slow, but...
You know Amelia Earhart?
No kidding. Man, they knew all the cool people.
Anyway, I was saying, yeah, sorry this is not like the most exciting level, but the last one was like, holy shit, old buildings falling down, jumping from ledge to ledge, getting a big fight with a girl, get shot at, fall off a cliff, and then Elena makes a surprise return, and then we go from that to this.
Damn it. Journals about everything in the world, but nothing for Mom.
It's a big house. Don't give up.
I'm gonna give up when I want to give up. Don't tell me what I can't give up on. Looks like a big egg. Big Fabergé egg over here. What's this? Another hat I can put on?
Samurai.
Just keep switching hats.
Do you recognize the crest?
Hollyhock leaves are, let's see. Don't tell me. Tokugawa clan.
Yeah, right, you are.
You think there's a trophy if I put on every hat in the house? I bet there's a trophy for putting on every hat in the house. I was right about knocking over all the rock cairns in Chapter 10, wasn't I? Well, maybe I'm taking a guess. I haven't looked at I've looked at the trophy list, but not the hidden trophy list.
I don't think Mom's journals are anywhere in here. Let's check upstairs.
This one's burned.
Is that a letter?
What's left of it? Someone wanted to buy their stuff. Guess they said no.
Not like they needed the money.
I wouldn't want to part with the stuff either.
Yeah, it's way too cool. I can't use the spiral staircase, can I? No, who just clutters every staircase and doorway with all... Like, even when you hoard, that's the one section you leave clear so you can move around. Like, my garage. There it is. All right, let's keep on walking. Nice big house. Carpet on the stairs. Wow, spare no expense. What's up, bro? A lot of stuff to explore. Where do you want to go first? I like the samurai helmet I got on, though. This is probably the dopest helmet yet. Nate Drake is the last samurai.
It's locked.
Indeed it is.
Mom's stuff might be in one of these rooms. We gotta find another way in.
So both of these doors are locked. How else do we get in? Is there a way to, like, climb around the ceiling or something? Did we go outside and hop in through the window? There's nothing so far that's at all suggested there's going to be platforming involved in this level. This has been a very sort of slow, easy break for the game. And it's nice that they kind of, they break up the, it would, if it was nonstop action the whole time, the game would kind of be monotonous.
The air vent. Up there.
Oh, yeah. That could get us into the room below it.
It could.
Not us. You.
What?
I can't fit in there. Can you handle it?
You kidding me? Can't handle it.
All right. Let's see what you got then.
Well, wait, how am I supposed to get to the vent? I'm supposed to climb on stuff? I'm supposed to climb on all the stuff? I'm supposed to climb on all the stuff. Okay. What are we doing now?
Are you ready?
Wait, why are we moving it this way? Oh, shoot.
Whoops.
Polaroid.
It's a Polaroid. Let me see. I think it still works. Come here.
A smile, all right?
Hey, they're taking a selfie. I bet that's one of those photos we find later in the game that one of them has framed. It's a good looking photo. Let's shake it some more. Shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it up, shake it up. Shake it up, shake it up. Shake it up. Shake it up. Real-time Polaroid development. Part of Uncharted 4.
Okay. Up here.
Dun 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 dun. Alright, just scurry along the wall above all these ancient artifacts, no big deal, no big deal. Look out for this other little tiger. Now just grab onto these. That's good enough that they can support your weight. Convenient of them to put that giant wheel there for no reason. Oh, there's a little alarm there, or a smoke detector. Look out. Look out, Nate. You don't want to set that off.
There.
I'll see you on the other side.
Okay. It's a good thing I'm not claustrophobic.
Yeah, it is a good thing. Which way do we go? Well, clearly the way I was about to. I'm just walking down the grate. Always big enough to fit people in, but never in real life. Come out! Let me in!
Oh!
Uh-oh.
Alright. Okay. I'm in.
Can you get the door open?
Hold on. It's locked from this side, too. Huh?
And look around. Is there a key nearby?
Codeine. Lots of painkillers.
She killed herself in her sleep. Now, the story has separated us from Sam. And I wonder if that's relevant. Another letter to read? What do we got here? From Edmund the Sun. Evelyn, I was hoping I wouldn't have to write this letter. I was hoping our last conversation made my intentions clear. I was hoping that ignoring your repeated attempts to contact me would eventually send the right message. Discovering you sent my daughter a check in the mail means the message was too subtle from someone like you. I don't need your money, and more to the point, I don't want your money. I can take care of my family fine without your help. It's insulting to both of your intelligence to pretend that your hollow gesture would somehow rekindle our relationship. What little was left of our bond died the moment you couldn't bother to show up for Dad's funeral. Right up to the moment he drew his last breath, he still loved you. I don't. I pray you find peace with whatever it is you've been seeking your entire life, but do not contact me or my family again, Edmund. Oh, that is fucking cold. Even...
Well, that's sad.
Even refer to her as Evelyn and not Mom. Oh, that's rough. That is rough. What do we got here? Ooh, it looks like a key.
Got it.
What's this? Another photo of the family before they all broke up and died? That's them. I have a key. Is that going to get me into one of the other rooms? Because this room I've already explored. There's not even... I could let Sam in, but what's the point?
So? Anything?
Didn't see any journals.
All right, well, we still got the other locked door, so... Come on.
I can't open that door, can I? Nope. Nope, I cannot. All right, so basically this is the final room in the entire house, and they've set it up in such a way where you know that this is the final room in the house. So this is the end of our, I think, the little chapter right here. This is something going to be good behind this door. That does it for this episode of Game Time. Thank you for watching. My name is John, and I hope to see you next time as we continue Uncharted 4.